speech contemptible. And about how you know, it's about the intentions, man. You know? So we
yeah, I go back up to the point we had brought out. 2 Corinthians 10:7.
Do ye look on things after the outward appearance? If any man trusts himself that he is Hamashiach, let him of himself think this again, that as he is Hamashiach, even so are we Hamashiach.
That should give you confidence to say it don't matter, man. It don't matter. It don't matter about who's the smartest. You got the best voice. You got that little Boosie voice, man. And you out here on the highway. It don't matter, man. You got a boy. Oh, dog. That Nate voice. It's June. You know that theatrical voice, it don't fucking matter, man. What matters is your heart, with your mind, your intentions. That's what matters at the end of the day, man. You know? Like when I used to get, you know, I used to question my, you know, anytime we do judgment, you gotta, in a hard area, you gotta seek counsel. I see counsel and judgment, and brother, I was telling the brother the other day, I said, man, the main thing the brother used to ask me, do we go on the highways? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Do we come to camp? Oh, well, you can't say nothing to him then. As long as he's doing the commandments and he's doing that, you know what I'm saying? You can't say nothing. You know, a brother might rub you the wrong way and be an asshole or be obnoxious to you. You know what I'm saying? Or like I said, rub you the wrong way, he might not. You know what I'm saying? That's what matters at the end of the day. It matters about your intentions, and the Most High I'll take care of the rest, man. You know? It don't matter how a brother performs. He might not be at your level.
Even if he coming on the highways unsincere, the Lord gonna have it been brought out, man.
Yep.
You know? So, like, hey, just do your part, you know? Hey, and that, man, I just wanted to speak on that right quick, too, because today, and I always hate this. When you go to the gym and you got, you know, you come in, you, first of all, you just sit down watching everybody else play because you know you got people on the way. You know what I'm saying? Then your people come, now you're ready to play ball. And y'all miraculously end up on the same team. And y'all get your ass whooped, man. You know, I'm trying to even it out, you know what I'm saying? But I'm like, all right, fuck it, I'm gonna roll with the squad I came with. And y'all get your ass lit up, man. You know what I'm saying?
Just say, hey, that's against y'all.
Yeah, you know, play your part, man. All right, play your part. And if you can do better to contribute to your team, then do so, man. And let everything else take care of itself. By that, I mean, as far as it's true, play your lot, man. Just do your part to get out of here.
If you come to play, come to play. You know, that's just like a nigga coming to truth and say, I'm gonna wait till I get my arsenal right, then I'm gonna go and hit the highways. You know, then a dude just say, the Lord is dark. I'm an Israelite. That's all I need to know. You know, and he do what he knows. You know what I'm saying? He just go out there head first. He ain't wait. Of course, you gotta wait till a certain amount. You know what I'm saying? You can't come out there and you ain't never dribbled a day in your life. You know what I'm saying? And things like that and expect to win. But as long as you got the basics, and you just say, fuck it. You know what I'm saying? I'm about to go out here. You know what I'm saying? That's what matters, man. It's the intentions, man. I give a fuck, man. Hey, Derek Fisher wasn't the best three-point shooter, you know? That man just played, man. All the best NBA players are the motherfuckers that played. Because really, everybody got a shot. Everybody got a dribble. Everybody, it's the motherfuckers that played. I don't give a fuck. You know what I'm saying? And then, of course, you get players. You know?
Iverson. Hey, like, I don't gotta go to practice. Let me know when this game's on. You know what I'm saying?
Cause he already put in the work.
That's what I'm saying.
He practiced when he was young.
Yep.
So you don't get that good not practicing.
Yeah, yo. Nigga, just, I never seen a nigga do pick up a ball and crossover Jordan. Crossover Jordan. When he was defensive player the year before. Yeah, man. Don't work like this. You're not gonna curse out these scoffers like Lahana, he just pick up the Bible like, oh, yeah, fuck the higher, blah, blah, blah. You gotta get your shit together, you know? You don't know who they are.
You're a bad dude. You're a bad dude if you come unequipped, man. You light your ass up, man.
And yell over you, man.
Stupid out here, man. Y'all can nine there, they'll tell your ass something.
Yeah.
What the hell you doing, man?
Hey, and that's why the scriptures say that you gonna have the ones that say, Lord, Lord, because they actually think that they're doing the right thing. You know what I'm saying? Because it said, did we not do wonderful works? Because you gotta remember, it's a right-hand side and it's a left-hand side. And they tell you Corinthians that that Satan got angels of light too, man. All right? So they actually think they doing the bidding of Yahweh Hashem Yahushai, but they doing the will of Yahweh Hashem Yahushai, but they doing it through Satan, man. Because they coming against the true man of Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. All right?
Looking for Beelzebub, man.
And they know the damn way that they done sold out, you know? Or that they ain't teaching the truth. But they going to try to be like, Lord, but we was using the name. We was doing this. We was, you know, but hey, it ain't going to work out like that, man. All right? The scriptures say, quench not the spirit. So how you gonna tell a camp that you gonna shut them down if they speak against the so-called white man? What if the spirit want that to come out?
Yeah. You know, push not the spirit, that's exactly it. You're trying to do anything against the truth of the word, man.
Yep.
Like, what if they come up, what if Edomite come up and ask you, what's our faith? That's the first question that came to my mind. What if Edomite come up and ask you, what about us, which happens?
Yeah.
I don't see myself on the sign, what's gonna happen to me? What you supposed to say then? We're not dealing with you. We're dealing with Israel. Not Shiloh, you know?
They probably take his number. We ain't really dealing with you on another day.
You're obligated to tell them, man, the Lord ain't dealing with you. You're only dealing with Israel, and the rest of the nation's going to be into hardcore slavery, and Esau going to do 1,000 years. They're going to be put to death, according to Obadiah. Ain't no way he's supposed to manipulate any of the scriptures. Because you're taking your power away from yourself, man. Our ability to be out here is off the spirit of the Most High, Yahweh Hashem Yahushai, man. He's the reason why we're untouched right now, man. He's the reason why we're still coming out here week after week. So the day that you deviate from his intentions is the day he's going to stop fucking with you, man. Talking about you're going to stop cursing out Esau. What the fuck you mean? You know what I'm saying? Everybody got to get judged. Every fucking body gotta get judged. That's what our job is. It starts at Israel and it ends with the heathens. That's our job. Our job is to have dominion over the earth. We should never be no bitch ass niggas and say, I ain't gonna say nothing to another nation and get them mad. We the motherfuckers that control everything. You don't have a kingdom mind if you sitting there and say, I ain't gonna tell an Edomite, who the fuck is Esau, man? See what I'm saying? Who the fuck is this cracker, man? That he get the right to not be told about his goddamn self when he the wickedest motherfucker on this planet Earth, man. Destroying everything, man. Fucking animals, fucking Mother Nature or nature itself. People, man. He's destroying everything. And I can't say nothing, man. But I can sit here and tell Jacob about what the fuck they doing. No, everybody get it. And Esau definitely did, because you ain't shit. You should be more timid to be talking about your own people, man. Because you don't know who the elect and who's not. That's who you should be really more timid. But you niggas, just like a fucking regular nigga, you ready to attack your own fucking people because Esau gave you the authority to do this shit, man. You know, that's why Crips and Bloods shoot up each other. Because ain't shit really going to happen, man. You know what I'm saying? I forgot, it was like a Chinese movie I was watching or... And it was a real life story where Edomite became a Chinese mafia boss or some dumb shit like that. And the Chinese was like, do not fuck with white people, man. Because when you fuck with white people, they gonna come down on your ass, man. You know what I'm saying? No, he was in the Italian mafia. It was an Edomite in the Italian mafia. And he was going against the Chinese. They told him, they said, it's a code. If anything you do, and they told both sides, don't fuck with white people. Then the Chinese dude killed the white dude. He's like, what the fuck you doing? They shot him because, you know, we don't have that. You're not supposed to have that type of fear when you come into the truth. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah,
yeah. You know? And basically when he did it, he's like, what the fuck? And he killed his ass, man. You know? because that's not how we rock. We don't give a fuck who it is. If you go against the grain, done. Unless the Most High deemed different, man. You know? It's like something dragging, a yellow dragon, a striped, a white dragon.
Yeah, it's like something like that.
Because
that was the name of the Chinese, the white dragon, huh?
Yep. That was the dude himself. It was an actual dude. It was like a depiction of a real life event. It wasn't an actual story. It was an actual white dude that became into, I don't know if it was an Italian or he was in the Chinese mafia, and he became the head of that motherfucker in that, you know. I don't want to digress too much, but we don't have no respect to persons, man. You know, ain't no don't talk to Israel, don't talk to the nigga woman. That's what a lot of niggas' problem is. Don't be cursing. You got a mama, I'm going to fuck out daddy too. Shit, what you mean? Your dad holds more rights than your mama do, man. You know? Your father has a right to dip in all kind of quivers and pussy. Your mom don't got that right. She got all kind of dicks that been in her mouth and all the kind of things like that. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's crazy, but you're not supposed to do that. You're not supposed to have multiple rides in you as a woman. You're supposed to come in the door with one ride in you, go out the door with one ride in you. That's how a woman's supposed to live. But niggas are holding mom in high regard. You know what I'm saying? And she been fucking this dude, that dude, you ain't seen nothing, man.
You ain't got four half-brothers.
Yeah, you got four half-brothers, you know? Four half-brothers, but your dad, you know what I'm saying? Your dad ain't got tied down with your mom. You got the fuck out of there, and you mad at him for life and shit, man. You don't want to fuck with your other brothers and shit like that. All that dumb shit, man. Shit, weak, you know? Dad, you know, dad be showing you love. He ain't like disowning you or nothing. Man, fuck that nigga. He ain't.
And then at the end, it'd be the, you know, the fucking, I ain't even doing it. Fuck these bitches. I'm not about to do it.
Let it burn. Matthew's 23:1. Then spake Yahushua to the multitude and to his disciples, saying, the scribes and the Pharisees sit in Moses' seat. All therefore, whatsoever they bid you observe, that observe and do, but do not ye after their works, for they say and do not. Yeah, so he's saying, whatever they're telling you, go ahead and do it. But don't be like them, because they're fucking hypocrites, man. You know? Like, they tell you don't eat pork, don't eat pork. You know what I'm saying? But to be an ass, don't be an asshole like them, man. Don't look up to them. You know, they're telling you right. They know the law. You know? 1 + 1 = 2. You know, but he's a hoe. He's a bitch-ass nigga. Don't follow that. You know?
For they bind heavy burdens and grievous to be borne and lay them on men's shoulders.
Yep, like tights. You know what I'm saying? Nothing wrong with paying tights. But they be extorting you, man.
Camp starter packages,
and you gotta do this. You gotta be ordained and do this.
Buy the rest of the breakdowns.
The Most High put the Spirit on you, and He have you united with fire to come out here and preach the word. But you gotta wait on a nigga to come and fucking knight your ass to come out and do the work, man.
It's like a Pokemon ass dude.
Yeah, he ready. He like level 80 and shit. You know what I'm saying? You got weight on the nigga and shit.
Damn.
When the Most High choose you, it's a rap, man. You unleash, man. That's why that account was given in Jeremiah. Because there's scriptures that say that there are so many things that happen, but, you know, it couldn't be written in the books. There's a lot of things that happened in the scriptures that wasn't written because it wasn't for our learning, man. You know? You could tell the Lord healed an ankle, He healed a kneecap, He healed a mind, He healed an eyeball. All you need to heal about 10 of them motherfuckers and you okay, I get the point. Idea. He can heal. You know what I'm saying?
I can't find it, I just go.
No, but the scriptures tell you that the Lord actually did so many miracles that if they wrote them all in a book, the whole world wouldn't be able to retain it, man. So that's how many miracles he did that didn't get written in the scriptures, man. So basically, whatever is in here, any and everything that's written in this book is meant for us to make it. It ain't nothing extra you need. It ain't nothing less that you need, man. All right,
this is it. You don't gotta go in the book and gash it. Like, niggas don't even go through the Bible. And I hate talking to people, nigga. I've been doing a lot of study. How many scriptures you know, man? You know, it's bad enough you gotta go through the scriptures. Not bad enough. It's so much you gotta go through the scriptures. Then you gotta go through it and get to the Hebrew and the Greek. And then you gotta connect the precepts. You know what I'm saying? Then you gotta go into the history. And you're asking in these fucking other books already? What the fuck are you doing? Get the foundation right, man.
It's Isaiah chapter 34, verse 16. Seek ye out the book of the Lord and read. None of these shall fail, none shall want here.